Very good morning to all of you. Welcome to Narayana online classes. Today I am going to discuss 10th class chemistry assignment. Topic is carbon and its compounds. Assignment number 29. In which the first one is write any one reaction as it is an oxidation reaction and also a combustion reaction. Combustion reaction means the substance which is completely burned in the presence of oxygen is called as a combustion reaction. Similarly, oxidation means the substance which can gain the oxygen, that is called as a oxidation. Simply we can say gaining of oxygen is called as a oxidation. Here for these two we write the one example. For example, here C plus O2 gives rise to CO2. Carbon react with oxygen to produce the carbon dioxide and heat. This is the example for oxidation reaction as well as combustion reaction. Next, coming to second one, why do sometimes cooking vessels get black and on a kerosene stove? Here we say generally the saturated hydrocarbons which is burned with clear blue color flame, but unsaturated hydrocarbons which is burned with yellow color flame with sooty. Sooty means which gives the carbon blackened. Okay, Namma. So here, why do sometimes cooking vessels get black means because even the saturated hydrocarbons also, when these are burned in insufficient oxygen, then which is also burned with the yellow color flame with sooty. Here, why the vessels are blackened means when the inlet of air getting closed. The inlet of the air getting closed, here what happened means the fuel gases does not undergo completely combustion, then which produce the sooty. Due to this reason, the cooking vessels get black. So here answer, if inlet of air getting closed what happened? If inlet of air getting closed, the fuel gases do not undergo complete combustion. And it produces sooty means carbon. That's why these reason the cooking vessels get black. So here which get black over the vessels. Next, coming to third one, expand addition reaction. Generally, the unsaturated hydrocarbons, these are undergoes the addition reactions. Unsaturated hydrocarbon means alkenes and alkynes. That means these are containing the between the two carbon atoms at least one double bond or a triple bond. These only undergoes the addition reaction. So here the unsaturated hydrocarbons are undergoes to the addition reaction and become to change into saturated hydrocarbon. Here, for example, Butyl 2-ene undergoes the addition reaction to produce the butyl 2-ene, which is undergoes the addition reaction and finally gives the butane. For example, CH3 triple bond CH3. Here four carbons, the second carbon contains the triple bond, so name is the butyl 2-ene, which is in the presence of the nickel catalyst, which is react with the hydrogen to produce the butyl 2-ene CH3 CH double bond CH CH3. Here four carbons, between the two carbon double bond is present, that's why butyl 2-ene. Again, which is also react with the hydrogen in the presence of the nickel catalyst to produce the CH3 CH2 CH2 CH3. Here four carbons, between the all the carbons single bond is present, that's why this is the butane. So here generally the unsaturated hydrocarbons, which is involved in the addition reactions to produce the saturated hydrocarbon. Next, describe with the chemical equation how ethanoic acid may be obtained from ethanol. The ethanol, which is undergoes to the oxidation reaction in the presence of the alkaline potassium permanganate or acidified potassium dichromate to produce the acetaldehyde, which is undergoes to the oxidation to produce the ethanoic acid. So the reaction we can write ethanol, that means ethyl alcohol, C2H5OH. In the presence of the alkaline potassium permanganate, KMnO4, or acidified potassium dichromate, K2CrO4, to produce the aldehyde. Again, which gives the ethanoic acid. The common name also acetic acid. So here we can write CH3COOH. This is about the chemical equation to get ethanoic acid from ethanol. Next, coming to last one, why do we call alkanes as paraffins? Explain the substitution reaction of alkanes. First, here we have to know about the what is the substitution reaction. Substitution reaction means an atom or group of atom in a compound which is replaced by an atom or a group of atoms. Another atom or a group of atoms, it is called as a substitution reaction. Generally, alkanes are undergoes the substitution reactions. And here, why do we call alkanes as paraffins? Here, because alkanes are which is less reactive compounds. That's why these are called as a paraffins. Para means little affinity. Affins means affinity. So which is a little tendency to undergoes to the reaction. That's why these are called as a paraffins. And which is undergoes to the substitution reaction. Generally, methane, CH4, this is the saturated hydrocarbon, it is also called as a paraffin. Here, methane, which is react with the chlorine in the presence of the sunlight, the hydrogen atom of the methane replaced by the chlorine and which produce the new compound. Finally, all the hydrogen atoms from the methane replaced by the chlorine atom. Here we can observe the reactions. CH4 react with chlorine in the presence of sunlight. to produce the CH3Cl plus HCl. Here Cl to react with the CH4, in that one hydrogen atom from the methane replaced by the one chlorine atom. So CH3Cl plus HCl. Again CH3Cl react with the chlorine in the presence of sunlight to produce the CH2Cl2 plus HCl. Here also one hydrogen replaced by the one chlorine atom. Next, this CH2Cl2 react with the again chlorine to produce CHCl3 plus HCl. Next, again this CHCl3 react with again chlorine to produce CCl4 plus HCl. Finally, we can get carbon tetrachloride. So all the hydrogen atoms from the methane, which is replaced by chlorine atoms. This is the substitution reaction. I hope you all have to understand very